March playing I'll Be Seeing You. It was a hugely popular song during World War II, telling the tale of missing someone who was serving away in the war. It was written by Sammy Fain and recorded by Bing Crosby, Billie Holiday, and Joe Stafford, to name a few. During this concert, we will be including memories from the 1940s submitted by our very own residents. The first is a memory from Phyllis Kylie Tyler. The summer of 1940 was a scary and uncertain time for me as an eight-year-old. We lived on a farm in the Skagit Valley near Conway in Mount Vernon. Our farmhouse was on a direct path to the Naval Air Station on Whidbey Island. A treasure for me and my friends became a set of cards showing the airplanes in detail that flew overhead every day. As kids, we were not included in the whirlwind of conversations and concerns of the adults around us, but we had our airplane cards. We studied them, played games with them, and traded them. But at night, it got scary because we couldn't tell which plane was flying overhead. Was it friendly or not? For our first song, we'll be singing Accentuate the Positive. It is one of the songs featured in the Great American Songbook. Published in 1944, it was written by Harold Arlen with lyrics by Johnny Mercer. It was featured in the film Here Come the Waves.
You got to accentuate the positive feeling. The negative and mind to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. in between. You're gonna spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum and have faith. Or pandemonium is liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate this last remark, jumping in the way, no one in the arm. What did they do? Just when everything looked so dark. You got to accentuate the positive feeling. And if the negative latch on to the affirmative, don't mess with Mr. in between. Don't mess with Mr. in between.
Our next memory comes from Carol Barrow. My grandfather was a chicken farmer and had a guy come by to pick up the eggs for sale. He didn't come one day and we wondered why. We learned that he had been picked up and taken to a Japanese internment camp. Our next song is The White Cliffs of Dover, written in 1941 and became one of the most popular songs of World War II. The song's lyrics of children sleeping in their own beds refers to England's Operation Pied Piper, when millions of people, most of them children, were shipped to rural areas in Britain as well as Canada, South Africa, Australia, and New Zealand. It was recorded by Vera Lynn and became a hit, bringing hope to the British for the war to end and peace to prevail.
There'll be love and laughter
From Sue Nice. One of my first childhood memories took place in New York's Bronx Zoo on a warm spring day in 1948 when I was 3 years old. My parents had me dressed in a bright pink sundress for this small family outing. Standing in my stroller, I was excited, leaning forward to watch the zookeeper throw his first round of fish to the seals. All the waiting seals jumped at once towards the descending fish with a loud, dramatic splash. So dramatic that to my parents' dismay, a tall wave of stinky pool water splashed up and completely doused me from head to toe. Oh no, you! Our next song is Mare's E-Goats, which was written in the 1940s and had trouble getting started because it was a silly song based on an old nursery rhyme. A year later, various artists recorded the song and it became an instant hit.
I know a ditty, nutty as a fruitcake, goofy as a goon, and silly as a loon. Some call it pretty, others call it crazy, but they all sing this tune. Mare's he dopes and those he dopes and little lads he divey, a kiddly divey too, what a cute. Mare's he dopes and those he dopes and little lads he divey, a kiddly divey too, what a cute. If the words sound queer and funny to your ear, a little bit jumbled and chimey. Say, mares eat oats, and doves eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy. Oh, mares eat oats, and doves eat oats, and little lambs eat ivy. A kiddly ivy too, wouldn't you? A kiddly ivy too, wouldn't you?
Our next memory comes from Margaret Brown. In the early 1940s, our dad had graduated from college in mechanical engineering and secured a job with Lockheed in California. Airplanes had fascinated him since he was a little boy. He was loaned to Boeing for work on the B-17 bomber, the Flying Fortress. While in Seattle, he met and married our mother. Years later, I worked at Boeing and saw pictures of severely damaged B-17s returning safely to base, holes shot through the wings and fuselage. For our next performance, we will have a solo of Sentimental Journey by Denise. It's a song that tells of someone about to take a train ride to a destination that holds a strong memory and attachment for them. Doris Day recorded the song in 1944 and it became her first number one hit.
Can't you stop? I could have
Memory comes from Donald Coles, who is the brother of Marge Schlegel, our pianist. The Ludendorff Bridge was a key component to the Allied and Axis powers of World War II. I played a part in the events of early March in 1945 since I was a member of the 291st Combat Engineer Battalion at the time. My part was to produce a map of the completed bridge by crossing it on foot, keeping track of the number of pontoons and the places where upstream anchors were attached. I did this while the bridge was being actively shelled and bombed, and I remember that I had to stop my first attempt and return to headquarters for a piece of chalk so that I could mark some of the pontoons and not lose track in all the excitement. I still have a copy of that map somewhere marked Top Secret. Our next song is Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree. It was a 1940 song that was made popular by Glenn Miller and the Andrew Sisters. It is about two young lovers pledging their fidelity to each other while he is away serving in the war.
Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. Anyone else but me, anyone else but me. No, 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 don't sit under that apple tree to nobody else but you. So just be true to me. Don't go walking down Lover's Lane with anyone else but me. Anyone else but me, anyone else but me. No, 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 don't start showing off all your charms in somebody else's arms. You must be true to me. I'm so afraid at the plans we've made with those moonlit stars. We'll fade away if you're bound to stray. Stars get in your eyes. So don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. Till I come marching home.
Our next reminiscence comes from Clarine Ackerman. When the war started, I was in grade school. My class helped the war effort by collecting tin foil. I collected tin foil from my dad's cigarette packages, from my family and friends and neighbors. My ball got really big by the time we turned them in. Our next song is The Surrey with the Fringe on Top. It's a show tune from the 1943 Rodgers and Hammerstein production of Oklahoma. It was based on the play, Green Grow the Lilacs.
Chicks and ducks and geese and surrey, when I take you out in the surrey, when I take you out in the surrey with the fringe on top. Watch that fringe and see how it flutters when I drive them high-stepping strutters nosy pokes will peek through the shutters and their eyes will pop. While the wheels are yellow, the upholstery's brown, the dashboard's genuine leather. With icy glass curtains, you can roll right down in case there's a change in the weather. Two bright side lights beeping and a-blinking. Ain't no fire rig, I'm a-thinking. You can keep your rig if you're thinking that a hair too soft for that shiny little Surrey with the fringe on the top.
Bob Willingham tells us, in 1945, I was shipped overseas to France. En route to Europe, while most of the men were asleep, our troop ship collided with a French aircraft carrier at 4 a.m., destroying the entire bow of our ship and sending hundreds of GIs to a watery grave. I managed to survive, but it was my first brush with the war casualties. I was a paratrooper. The biggest problem was that there were so many of us in the air at the same time. The only thing holding you up 1,500 feet above the ground was a fragile canopy. The challenge was to avoid getting tangled up in the other parachutes. I often had to lift my legs up to make rapid steering changes. The next song is Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. It was the number one hit of World War II. It was performed by the Andrews Sisters and tells the story of a bugler who had been drafted into the Army. It was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1999. Here are the Andrews Sisters, then and now.
Sisters.
Okay.
Believe it or not, the first time we did it, two of our caregivers thought Denise was in trouble.
You're going to save me.
Another memory comes from Phyllis Kylie Tyler. Added to the concern for our safety were blackouts. That meant no lights would show out of your house, garage, barn, or yard. Our windows were all covered with large plywood curtains. It was always dark inside our house with only one light allowed on in the kitchen. I remember listening to the frightening news on December 7, 1941 on our little radio, with my mother and sister wondering what the world would look like when I could look out my windows again, and when would that be? You Are My Sunshine is a timeless song released in 1939 and recorded by only over 350 artists. The song is actually about being dumped and wishing the other person would stay. Most people miss this because they only know the upbeat chorus.
The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, a dream I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. I'll always love you and make you happy. If you will always stay the same. But if you leave me to love another, you'll regret it all someday. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You'll make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. You told me once, dear, you really loved me, and no one else could come between. But now you've left me and love another. You have shattered all. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Thank you.
Nagel told us, my family had a bungalow at the Jersey Shore. At sunset, the Coast Guard patrolled the beach on horseback. Yeah, if I was in the vicinity when they came by, I would be straddled on front of the young men and given a short horsey ride. 4 year old heaven. The Coast Guard also got medicine for me when it was unavailable to civilians. We all loved those coasties. I also remember being awakened in the middle of the night to talk on the phone to my brother who was stationed in Guam. Mom always had tears in her eyes. Our next song, Don't Fence Me In, was written by Cole Porter. It was derived from a poem about Western life and became known as a cowboy's lament about the encroachment of city life on the American West.
Wildcat Kelly looked at my bail, standing by the sheriff's side. When that sheriff said, I'm taking you to jail, Wildcat raised his head and cried.
Oh, give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you to please. Don't fence me in. Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western sky. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west mound ends. Gaze at the moon until I lose my senses. Can't look at cobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
Wildcat Kelly sitting by his sweetheart's side. When his sweetheart stepped come on the sundown, Wildcat raised his head and cried.
Oh, give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you, please, don't fence me in. Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my tires, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences. Gaze at the moon until I lose my senses. Can't look at owls and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
Claire Chamberlain, in 1946, noticing that I was a novice skater, the ice guard offered to skate with me. At the end of the session, he offered to drive me home. After that came dates, marriage, and 5 children. Next, we have Cruising Down the River, written by 2 middle-aged women and that won a public songwriting competition in 1946, held in the United Kingdom. It was even sung by the crew of the HMS HMS Amethyst as it made its way down the Yangtze River in 1949.
Cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon with one you love, the sun above, waiting for the moon. And oh, the cornet playing a sentimental tune. Cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon, the birds above all sing above a gentle sweet refrain. The winds around all make a sound like softly falling rain. Just two of us together will plan a cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon.
Jim Schoenecker told me over breakfast one day, "I remember when it was announced that the war was over. There were horns and sirens blasting in our small town to celebrate. Later, the planes carrying the troops home flew low over the town with the plane doors open and the soldiers waving to us on the ground." Next, we have the Armed Forces Medley with the anthems of the U.S. branches of the service: Marines, Army, Air Force, Coast Guard, and Navy. For our resident veterans, please wave the flag you were given when you came, when your branch of the service is sung.
Marines!
Thunder, and the boys, here they come.
Down we dive, sprouting our flame from under. Off with one hell of a roar. We live in fame, go down in flame. Ain't nothing can stop the orbit's inner course. Navy.
Originally in 1918 and then later revised in 1938. It became an overnight hit and a hopeful song for Americans as war threatened. It is an expression of gratitude for what our country has done for its citizens and what home really means. It became Kate Smith's signature song and the unofficial national anthem of the United States. Please join us for the chorus found on the back of your program.
As the storm clouds gather, far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair. As we raise our voices in a song of praise,
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the ocean, right before. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountains to the prairies to the ocean, right before. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless
nation, because we only have one really good mic. First of all, I'd like an extra round of applause for Marge, our pianist. There is actually one more memory. Unfortunately, it came in too late to be included in the program, but I wanted to share it with you anyway. Many people on Palm Front. Creative ways to support the war effort. Judy, this comes from Judy Nagel. Judy lived in a close-knit neighborhood where most of the young people had gone off to war. The neighbors discovered a certain shortage for the troops. It was a shortage that we ourselves can identify with as we experienced it at the beginning of the pandemic. So, they got inventive. They wrote letters to the troops on toilet paper. That way, the troops could get their news from home and then use the station for its intended purpose. We hope that you have enjoyed this walk down memory lane. If you'd like to have a copy of the memories, there is a printed version of them in the back, and you can pick one up on your way out. So thank you again for coming.
Thank you.